2013, the Vietnam War is one that we will certainly never forget.
Oh my goodness, no. And while much has been made of the conflict, which officially ended, what, in 1975, little has, well, how about this? I don't think you've ever heard of this group, and you should, because we have a very special person here with us today. Let me just say this. It was the Battle of Fire Support Base Ripcord, and Karen knows all about it. Man, this is a special moment
so
for us.
I guess this was the last major battle for the United States Ground Forces. Is that accurate?
Chanel, you got it. Let me set the stage for folks. Let's remember back 1969, we've got President Richard Nixon, who's actually pulling the troops secretly out of Vietnam at the time. So the last major battle is this battle, the last major offensive, Ripcord. It goes on for 23 days. I want you to take a look at this emblem, because this is a story, and these are the men that were there, and these were young guys, 19, 20, 21, and the group of the men that you're going to meet, oldest one is 24. Take a look at the story that most of us don't know anything about.
I was surprised when I first realized how little anybody knew about it.
Well, Ripcord was a fire base that we operated around back in 1970 in actually just outside the Ashaw Valley in Vietnam.
At a time when we were supposed to be, you know, withdrawing, we were in the process of a major escalation.
It was one of the 10 worst battles in Vietnam.
A battle that lasted 23 days.
I assumed I was going to be killed that day.
It was bigger than anyone would have imagined, especially for those who ended up in the middle of it.
Each of us carried around 400 rounds of ammunition.
In what would be the last major conflict between members of the U.S. Army 101st Airborne Division and the North Vietnamese Army.
We were operating in an area north of Ripcord. My company had been in that area about 2 weeks prior. It was in a bunker complex that at the time we went through was deserted. But I guess somewhere in that two-week period, they had all moved into that area.
They being the North Vietnamese soldiers, and the hilltop was crawling with them.
They opened up on us and we were trapped, and I got hit early. I guess I blacked out for a couple of seconds and then realized I had been hit in both arms, all across the chest. My leg had been almost completely blown away.
Okay, right there. Go ahead.
And yet somehow he managed to get cover. His story, not unlike a lot of those shared by servicemen who took part in that 23-day confrontation that sadly too few of us in this country even know about.
It was kept quiet. It wasn't classified or anything. It was just never told. They didn't want anybody to know about it at the time. They kept the press from being there. They were banned, and the media was banned from coming out to the hill. We were attacked by 400 NVA. We fought them all day long. I was wounded three different times in that one day. There was only six left that weren't wounded or killed. And we had to wait the whole night until another Delta Company came in the next morning to rescue us.
It was Freddie Gilbert's job to help bring the U.S. troops home.
Where we were supposed to land was on fire. I mean, not only on fire, it was covered by enemy fire. There was people dead everywhere.
And yet that didn't stop him from going in and rescuing his fellow Americans.
I was the first American that they had seen after fighting 24 hours hardcore.
He just bullied his way right through the jungle and grabbed hold of me and just drug me off that hill.
The grace of God brought us all out of there. I died for him tonight, and then me. True. We don't know any different.
And
And right now this morning, we want to thank for coming down this morning. We've got Frank and Freddie, we've got Lee, we've got Sam, we've got Dennis, all members of the 101st who fought for 23 days in that battle. And initially, gentlemen, this was a covert operation and you guys didn't have news media reports. We weren't allowed there back in that day. So you didn't even know how to find each other. We didn't know about this to 1985.
1985, the Ripcord Association started with about 12 members, and now we're up to about 600 Ripcord veterans.
Just struck by, I can't imagine fighting for 23 days. You were hit three times. The two of you were hit in this last day. 76 guys, all but four wind up wounded, and then this guy over here saves you?
Yes, he came up the next day. The next morning, his company came up and rescued us.
What was that like?
Real scary. I was a point man, and it was a hard job. And like I say, the commander said, get ready, it's a bad mission. And some of you ain't gonna come back. I'm gonna do my best to get y'all out. That meant laying dead and dragged out. But I was a point man in D Company.
Gentlemen, thank you all for your service. We appreciate you coming down. We thank you what you did for us then and what you still do for us, and we're really proud of all of your service. All right, I'm going to send it back in an amazing story. Wow. Mike and Chanel, back to
remarkable.
You guys.
And back in the 70s, you know, thank you, the government wouldn't tell us that they were still over there.
So everybody else was rescued. They're still behind.
Well, they've been brought home. The war is winding down. It's over, but they're still there fighting.
They're still there. And no one knows?
No.